My name is Emile Ferris, and I wrote a book called My Favorite Thing is Monsters, because my favorite thing is monsters. And so is my protagonist's favorite thing. Her name is Karen Reyes. She lives in Chicago in 1968. And she loves monsters. And she is a monster. And the book is about the fact that we're all monsters, except for the villagers, who are monsters but don't know they are. A monster is everybody. Yeah, I mean, it's what we are. There comes a point where you give up on the fact that being different is a bad thing because you're different and there's no other way that it's going to work out for you unless you live in the fullness of your difference and enjoy it. I think she's approaching that point in her life where she can really do that. She still has difficulty with it. The second book deals with that fact that, you know, she confronts the pain of being different again and again and strategizes about ways to embrace it, embrace even the pain of it through writing, through drawing. My D's, Karen's D's, pushes her from the age of very young to the paintings and says, go in. And Karen goes in. And she, that's her whole life, is to go in and find what's inside of the paintings. And they solve riddles for her. They become clues about how to be an adult and maybe how to live in the fullness of her monsterhood. Well, there's definitely intense feeling in her for monsters, for art. I mean, she doesn't see any difference between the pulp covers of Eerie and Weird, which I reprise as Ghastly and Dread. She doesn't see any difference between those and the paintings in the Art Institute of Chicago, nor did I. And of course she has things like Mad Magazine, and she has, you know, horror movies like Bride of Frankenstein and Picture of Dorian Gray, and these are the places wherein she feels expansive. And she can live, and she can be in that cemetery at night. She can be in that castle. She's welcomed in those places. She's not really welcomed in the village, and she already knows that, you know. The book really began when I was Karen. I mean, it began in notebooks and journals that I did as a child, and this book is a reprisal of those. I studied the world, you know. I didn't walk until I was maybe almost 3 years old because my feet didn't grow. I was, you know, I had scoliosis pretty severely. So I was lucky. I had parents who, especially my mother, gave me drawing equipment. So I couldn't walk on my own, but I could look at the world and draw it. And it became the way that I experienced the world, as opposed to what a child would do when they can walk to something and touch it. I couldn't touch it. I couldn't get things down from a shelf or get things off the table. So I drew them. And so that's where it begins. That's where the book begins. And so the book took approximately 4 years to draw. And it's essentially 800 pages, although I've revised the last 400 pages because it needed to be done. The book wasn't right until now, until recently. And it began as a short story, as a screenplay. It began really, the first moment was a vision I had of this beautiful, and I can start crying if I talk about it. This beautiful trans man young man who's black and his face is all scarred. And I saw him open his raincoat and I saw this little werewolf girl come into it. And I said, who are you? You know, who are you? And they told me, you know,